Yo, it's your boy No Name.
It's your boy Nightsong, back at it again.
So welcome back for now. Welcome back to Unpopular Opinions, a weird episode. What we got, Nighttime?
Alright, so we're gonna talk about some slang.
New York slang.
Unpopular opinion, right at the start. We're the only people who talk like this, and it's the best type of talking ever. Besides British people.
I don't like British people. But on the real, New York slang, you go anywhere else in the country, you won't find it. Anywhere else in the world,
you won't even understand what we're saying.
You won't find it. I have a friend that goes to school in upstate New York. He said, he just uses the slang, talks how he normally does the first day there, and nobody could understand what he was saying, even though, he's speaking English.
Hey, it be like that sometimes.
It do be like that. I'm telling you, that's from New York, bro. That's not from memes. That saying is from New York.
Nowhere else, bro.
What's the first thing you want to start with? We can start with the welcome, bro. What we say? We say,
bro, so a little history behind that. There's no real history. It's just people calling. You know how they had a cat call? You know how people catcall and stuff like that. So it's kind of like our version of catcall, but instead it's not just the females. It's to everybody, bro. It's to your homie, your son, your brother, your sister, your mother, your father, on the phone. It don't matter who you talking to. We can hit them on a year. And one thing you cannot forget, you always respect the year. You hear the year?
Yeah, you gotta respond with a year. Listen, though, the one thing we do argue about is I spell year with a U, he spells it with an E.
Bro, it's Y-E-R, right?
It's Y-U-R. Like, when you type your in text, bro, it was your.
Nah.
It's not year.
Leave it up to them
it's
decide.
Your.
They'll decide.
Man, bro, I got you. The next one we got, bro, is brick.
No.
And I use this a lot in the winter.
Y'all don't know what this means, bro.
Brick means cold. Like, but do you have any history
frosty.
Behind brick? Why is brick used for a cold?
Alright, so you know when the cold air be hitting you, and it hurts, like it's hard, bro.
Yeah.
Like a brick. That's where it came from.
The explanation I got from my friend Sisa Yame, shout out to him. He said it's they use brick for its cold outside because bricks are outside. I was like, yo, what is this explanation? He was like, bricks are outside. That's and the- bricks, when they're hot, they're really hot. And when it's cold, they're really cold. So I was like, I don't know about that, bro, but
that's the most New York explanation.
Exactly, bro. Brick. Like, come on now.
Bricks outside.
Exactly. Well, which one you got, man?
So since we just talked about a cold, let's warm it up real quick. And we got another one. We say that's fire, bro.
That's true. That's fire. That's heat.
So there's different ways to spell it. So you can get F-Y-E. I've seen people do F-Y-E. And you just have the normal fire, F-I-R-E. It doesn't matter.
I'm pretty sure this originated from hip-hop, yo. No cap.
Yeah, because...
Some New York rapper. I can't name you. There's so many. Probably this and it got popular. You know what I'm saying? We say fire instead of cool. But then sometimes we say cold instead of fire.
Yeah,
like
we say
cold.
That's cold.
We don't say cool because that's a little, I don't know,
that's
not New
that's
York
not
enough.
Cool, bro.
Yeah, it's cold, man.
It's cold.
And like staying on that topic of ice cold, bro, water, especially in basketball, you have a shot that's wet. Like, why is your shot wet and why do we call it water?
And you know what's crazy? They were just having that whole water is wet debate. And you know what nobody ever said?
What?
Well, when I shoot the ball, it's water, right? But when I also shoot the ball, it's also wet. So water is wet. Nah, we're not going to get into that.
Yeah, we're not going to get into that. This man was a lie. Okay, bro. Okay. Let me hear one that you got, bro. Let me hear one that you have.
All right, so what about, you know how everybody be saying sleep?
Sleep? Yeah,
bro.
Shword?
Yeah, it originated from Bobby Shmurda. We all know that.
Yeah, is the S-H and the S-C-H, bro.
Bobby Shmurda got it.
Add it in front of any word and it's automatically New York slang.
It's automatic.
Like, yo, I was sleeping yesterday. I was schlept. That's shwavy instead of that's wavy. We're going to talk about that's wavy later, too, but that's shwavy. You know what I'm saying? It's like slang on top of slang. Another one I got is word two.
Word two?
Word two. Like word, it's like two different things. Word two, like, it's like you're like swearing on something. Like when people say word to my moms, it's like, I swear on my moms, I'm telling the truth.
It's
right?
like
but then it's also like when you're agreeing
God.
With, yeah, on God.
Because we say that too sometimes.
We still say that. But then the second meaning is like the original meaning of the slang word, like I agree with you. Like you say something and somebody else is like word. You know what I'm saying?
And word by itself just being like, for real?
Yeah, exactly.
I bet.
Now, I see another one listed that I know you want to get to. So, you know what I'm saying. It's one. Yeah, you got to get to it, bro.
Hey, yo. I know. Shout out to my ox everywhere, bro. Because y'all don't know what bacon, egg, and cheese means, bro.
That's one word.
Bacon, egg, and cheese.
When you go into the deli, you're like, "Ayo, ok, let me get a bacon, egg, and cheese." Ok, we're gonna get to that next, but that's one. But bacon, egg, and cheese is the official fruit of New York.
Facts. I just saw that the other day.
Yeah.
And I was just like, as it should be. You know exactly. How long we've been waiting for that?
I don't know. Bro. I don't know. You listen. Philly has Philly cheesesteak. We got the bacon, egg, and cheese. Yo, chopped cheese. We got chopped cheese.
Yeah, we got that.
Oh my god, bro. We got good sandwiches over here in New York, bro.
In fact, y'all gotta stop by. You know, let us know.
Exactly. We're back to ok. There's like two different means, bro. Ok slash Aki. You go into the deli, you say ayo ok. You're talking to the person behind the counter or the cook.
And you're just saying let me get something.
Exactly. And then Aki is a way to describe somebody who's just buff, mad muscular. You know, they mad strong. Like, yo, that dude is Aki.
And another way to say Aki, we say brolic. But like, brolic, everybody,
yeah,
say
everybody
brolic.
Says brolic now.
Nah, but they originated from us, of course.
Of course. We got another double meaning one, son and sunned. So, you know what I'm saying? People be like, yo, that's my son to somebody they know. Like, that's my bro, that's my homie, all that, you know? And then there's sunned. Like, if you're playing a game of basketball and somebody dunked on you, you got sunned, bro. Like, it's like the sunned with an E-N-D, I mean, with a N-E-D is the disrespectful one. And then son is a respectful one. I know it's kind of confusing, but yeah.
But you know, it'd be like that. And then after that, we got the adjectives right here.
Yeah, bro, the adjectives. We got a dumb, mad, and OD, which all of them kind of mean the same thing a little bit.
True. And if you put any of these in front of any word you're gonna say, anything,
it's
automatically hypes it up. By
that's true. That's true too. That's true.
Automatic,
bro. Like, yo, that movie we saw last night was dumb lit. Exactly. That movie we saw last night was OD lit.
Not even, bro. That movie last night was mad lit, bro. You can even say dumb valid, dumb anything.
And dumb, no, dumb, I got you. Dumb shvalid.
Shut up. You going way too far on that one.
That's too many, bro. Yeah, that's another thing. Like, when you use New York slang, there's like an art piece to it, bro. You cannot use too much of it, or then you just look like a fool.
You're just a tourist.
Exactly. You're just a tourist. Now, oh, yo, tight. When you're mad, you don't say I'm mad, because as we said, mad is a quantifier. So we replaced it with this word called tight. People say, yo, you're getting me tight. They're doing something that's annoying you. Exactly. Can you explain that?
So here we go. So tight is like, it originated from when you were in a tight spot. That's pretty
tight situation.
It.
Yeah, so like, basically.
You're mad. You're like going crazy. You're tight.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then with the quantifier, I'm mad tight.
Yeah. I'm dumb tight. Dumb tight.
OD tight.
Exactly. Automatically sends it to another level, bro. This one is kind of new. Yo, and there's like this one and capping and out of pocket.
Out of pocket.
I swear on my life these came from the Giants, bro. Because these are football terms, bro. Like, your cap space on a team, bro. So you're capping. You're going past the space you should be, bro.
Exactly.
And it's the same thing with out of pocket. That's like, exactly. The quarterback gets out of pocket. He's not supposed to be out of pocket. So it gets people angry. You getting them angry if you're out of pocket. Yo, that's my explanation for it. You know what I'm saying? You got an explanation for it?
It's pretty much the same exact explanation. Like you said, with the capping. The capping. It's pretty much you just being sped.
Exactly.
That's the only way to say it.
Exactly.
Out of pocket means you're out of line, bro. You're just out of line.
Actually, that's probably the best one right there. You're just out of line. You know
just
what I'm saying?
Out of pocket, bro.
Now, the next one is actually kind of a classic that's become a meme. B.
Bro, if y'all don't understand what B means, y'all gotta go.
Originally, B is just like, bro. Like, it's literally, they just took out the R and the O. Now it's like anything, yo.
Now it's just Tim's B, anything B.
Yeah, another thing. Nike. Bacon, egg, and cheese is the official fruit of New York. The Tim's is the official fit of New York.
Yeah, facts. If you don't got the fitted with the Nike Tech and the Tim's on,
you're
don't
not
know
a New Yorker.
You
don't have to be wearing it, but you must have it in your closet somewhere.
Exactly.
And in the winter, the Tech never comes off.
Never off.
You shower with it.
In the summer, and never off. Nah, I'm capping.
You capping. You out of pocket. Anyway, oh, yo, capping, no cap.
Yeah, all right. So no cap is a controversial one. You're gonna see people all over the internet swearing it's there. Nah, it's ours, bro. So no cap is just us saying, like, it's just, you remember when we said on God? Remember a little while ago we talked about on God and we were talking about what was the other term we were talking about?
Word.
We were talking about word too, word. No cap pretty much means I'm not lying, bro. Don't even try to explain that. No.
The situation no I just explained, exactly.
If I said I ain't do it, bro. No cap. Bro, no cap I can't find anything.
Exactly. That's right.
This is fire.
The next one we got is just Wavy, which we already kind of explained a little bit.
So it came from, you know, everybody was out here looking fresh with the waves.
With the waves, yeah.
Everybody's looking fresh. And when your waves looking swavy, oh my gosh.
Wavy, when you use it to describe anything, is basically like, yo, that's elite, good. Bro, it's elite.
Good,
it's
nice,
looking nice. Anything. Yeah, man. It's just an adjective. Then we got slaps. I usually use this with food, yo. Like, for yo, fact. That bacon, egg, and cheese slap. Can y'all figure it out? If you can't, a nighttime will explain it.
So pretty much, bro, slaps is just a banger. It's just anything that's valid, bro. It's just straight up. Remember when you had the adjective? Slaps is the word without the adjective. Is that hype without the adjective? You don't even need to add the adjective there.
And it's technically a verb.
I don't even think you can.
It's technically a verb.
You know what?
Yeah. Slaps would be a verb.
That's
a verb, but the way you use it is like an adjective. It's weird, man. Slang is weird. And now we got one of the most classic ones, and then, you know, caution into the wind here. Disclaimer, it's not a cuss word, but dead ass,
bro. So let me talk about this real quick. So ass in every form of speech is a prefix and a suffix, bro. We can use it whenever we want. Dead ass, bro. On God. Facts. Dead ass just means facts, bro. If you don't know what facts means, I'm sorry, but dead ass is just
like facts. Is self-explanatory. It's not even slang. It's just like, it's true.
Come
it's
on,
a fact.
Man.
It there's is undisputable. You know? I mean, man, there's probably a lot more terms out there that we didn't cover. Y'all probably got in the comments section, but that's the one we could come up with, bro.
A short banger. We got more.
We got more like non-sports ones coming up. You know what I'm saying? We out here writing anime and whatnot. Y'all stay tuned, man. Started with a year, ended with a year. Thank you.